So it's about 1 o'clock here at the shop. I was going to work with my buddy Tyler Bays. We're shooting more footage today for his YouTube channel and just for other content and all that. Anyway, so I went and did that. Forgot to vlog at all. Sorry, guys. Still getting back into the rhythm of things, but I promise you next time I will and kind of show you what's going on there. But came back to the office. Another order was placed for some shirts that need to be done in 2 days. We usually don't take on orders that short notice, but honestly, I don't really know why I did. I just decided to. And I guess I was feeling it. Now, I came up here to burn some screens, and it's not going how I wanted it to. Really just kind of getting frustrated right now. I'm actually really trying hard to keep my cool right now, but I'm going to go plan my day tomorrow. We had to pull out of a show that we were going to be showcasing Southern Harry's products at. So really just kind of been, it's been a good couple days because it's been busy, but it's also been frustrating at the same time. So I'm going to go home, going to get some sleep, going to plan, and just clear my mind and come back tomorrow and kill it later. So, like I said, we had to cancel out of a show that we were going to be vendors at this weekend. We are putting our stuff in my brother-in-law's shop, SPO Slim Pickens Outfitters. We're putting our clothing in his booth, but we've been trying to find a solution to this, okay? So, we had these woven labels made up. This one was going to go on like the inseam above that, and then so it was just going to show small and then have ours up there or whatever the size is, and then this one, it folds, goes from purveyors to the dog graphic, it folds, and we're going to put that like on the seam like down here. Well, we cannot find anyone that can sew these into our pieces. It's been a frustrating thing. Hopefully one of these days we'll be able to find someone, but we've went to countless amounts of people. And then we're gonna screen print it, but it's super time sensitive. We need to get this stuff out. So what I'm gonna do is go in with the razor blade and cut off the alternative pearl one and leave that one, because this is, I know you think like you don't want a tag in there, but this is like a super soft one. It feels as good as the shirt. So that's not gonna be an issue. And if we leave it in there, it still looks nice, it still looks clean. And it's a fast solution to this, and that way we can get our line that's supposed to honestly go up in the fall, it's finally gonna go up now. It's definitely not how we anticipated this, but it's just what happened with the new business. Sometimes these setbacks happen. We're gonna do it and then start working on our spring and summer line and hopefully flip these around and sell them fast. And if not, a lot of it are pieces that we'll be able to carry over into next fall. So it's things to know for the future. I mean, like I've said before, this is a learning experience. I've never done this before, so learn as you go. And now we are more geared for our spring and summer launch, which I'm super excited about. All right, so I have the clothing all boxed up and ready to go in the car. Now I'm about to head up to Steubenville to give it all to Jamaica. Time to get on the road.
What?
Are you recording something?
Oh, you're good.
Okay, I was like, my feet are...
Currently uploading a video for Tyler's YouTube channel. It's gonna be a really funny one. It's going up, it's for his Funny Friday series. It's something that I'm gonna be featured in a lot as well. It's gonna be fun. I'm sorry if I'm blurry right now. I think I definitely was, and I might still be. Anyways, now Man, I'm honestly behind right now, and I don't know how. Now I just have a lot to do. So, I just watched the video back that I got done editing for Tyler's YouTube channel. And it is good. It's funny. But there are things in it that... So, our audio that we were trying to get for it, it got put on a corrupted card. So, we didn't have any of the audio. So, we had to use the in-camera audio. And I didn't even have a microphone for it or anything. So, we had to, like, blast it way up, turn it way up and everything. And so, the audio is really screwy on it. And there was one clip in there where it faded out into like a wide angle. I didn't turn down the volume on the radio. That was like far away. Oh man, it's little things like that that drive me crazy. I watched it back like 3 times, but I guess I somehow that was an oversight on my part. If it was like an actual real short film, you know, I would go back and put that up. The point of this is kind of just to get it out there and get up content. And just let you guys know, mistakes are okay. And even if they drive you crazy, it's better to get out your content than to not. And that's more going to me than you, because that is something that I really need to work on. I keep working on something and working and working and working until it gets perfect. And in reality, nothing's ever going to be perfect. So you will just keep working and working until you never put it out, because I have created countless amounts of things that I have not put out to the world. And really it's because I get insane anxiety on it not being perfect and not being up to my standards. And I really need to realize that nothing is ever going to be perfect. And just to put it out, because it's a learning process, you're growing, and it's okay to look back in 5 years and be like, wow, that's awful. But it was the step to get to where I am now. A little bit of advice right there, but I just now watched it back, and there are things on it that are driving me crazy. So...